Let's talk inflation. South Africa accelerated to a 30-month high in May, quickened to 5.2% year-on-year in May, up from 4.4% in April, highest level since November 2018, also marginally above the 5.1% predicted from a consortium of analysts. Joining us to talk inflation across Africa is Moshope Arubai, economist with Inflection Capital Asset Managers. Moshope, you're very welcome. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
Within the wider context of these inflation numbers coming out of South Africa, how do you view the macroeconomic story?
So South Africa's inflation has pretty much been evolving in line with consensus expectation, as you had mentioned, and also the central bank's expectation as well. Earlier in the year, year to date, we've seen a situation whereby inflation has been rising gradually, and this was not, this is pre-anticipated because we've seen oil prices inch higher, and that segment contributes about 25% to South Africa's CPI, unlike Nigeria, where it's just about 17% contribution. So it was expected that inflation would inch up as oil prices continue to extend their recovery. Yeah. And so we've seen that, and the central bank has also taken that into consideration in setting their targets. So basically, the inflation trend has been evolving in line with their expectations, unlike some parts of Africa where you have inflation much far away from the target. Exactly.
Yeah, so, like double the target.
Exactly.
Right.
And I expect that to continue over the next 18 months. You'd see the inflation oscillating like in the midpoint of the central bank's target over the next 18 months.
Oh, okay. So you preempted my next question. So I was going to ask for the outlook. So that is your outlook. It's going to keep oscillating between that range
Within South Africa. For the second half of the year, the pressure would be a bit more than the first half of the year, because we also expect that oil prizes will continue to recover. However, there will be some tempering effect from rand strength. The rand has strengthened about 3% year to date against the US dollar, and it's predominantly because of their robust exports that they've seen this year, and also slight increase in imports. So they have a positive current account position that has supported the strengthening of the rand. That trend should continue in the second half of the year and should temper the pass-through impact of higher oil prices on domestic consumer prices in South Africa. But second half of the year, generally, the pressure will still be higher. I expect about 4.3 average compared to about 4% average for the first half. But for the full year, of course, pressure will be much more than what we had last year. Last year was about 3.4% average.
Okay.
This year we should be expecting about 4.2. So that's 90% VIPs or close to 100, much stronger than last year. But even though I don't expect the central bank's monetary policy stance to change. I expect them to be accommodative. We've seen what's happening in the global space. The Fed is not aggressive about raising rates.
Right.
So the risk of capital flight in the short term is
not there.
Significantly low.
Okay.
And then they have a good external position as well on the back of the recovery, which should continue. So I don't see them under any pressure to adjust their monetary policy stance in the near term.
Great stuff. I've been looking forward to doing this. We've got inflation figures across a number of other African nations, inclusive, I think, what we got? Ghana, Senegal, Nigeria, and South Africa. I think we put that. Yeah, there they are. What's happening? Yeah, very interesting. Can you give us a quick view of what's going on in Ghana? I mean, it's 7.5% there for me, but how are they looking at the macro level?
Well, that's another country that is poised to enjoy decent macroeconomic health this year.
Mm.
They rebounded in, I think, Q4. The growth rebounded in Q4. External sector, they're not doing badly. And this is reflected in their exchange rates. The CDI has also appreciated slightly, not as strong as the rand. But it's firmer about 0.3% against the US dollar, which just reflects that they're in a good position externally, even though their debt profile is not fantastic.
Yeah.
But overall, I think from the external side, they're positioned to benefit from either market, risk off, risk on, because of the structure of their exports. And that's really doing well for them. Hence, they're able to contain their inflation, even though their import bill is significantly large. They're able to contain their inflation within the central bank's target. So for this year, they also look to they look like they'll do quite well. Maybe not as strong as South Africa inflation numbers, but yeah, they look like they'll be contained within the central bank's target this year as well.
All right, I want to ask you about Senegal. I also want to put up food inflation for these four African nations. Senegal 1.3% headline, but even there, if we look at that. So what's happening with Senegal? How is their inflation so incredibly low? Tell us.
I mean, generally, for you to achieve anything that has to change macroeconomic outcomes has to be the quality of your policy structure and a number of other things that are more country-specific. Mm. Senegal also has had a history of volatile and high inflation. They had that up to the mid-1990s, where you had inflation or an alternative between inflation and deflation in quick succession. But over from mid-90s, they implemented like some aggressive economic reforms that initially stoked the economy. At that time, we saw inflation go as high as 32%. Once those reforms came in.
Wow.
But in recent years, we've seen the dividends of those reforms play out.
Yeah.
The inflation has been relatively low.
Very
and
low.
Stable.
I cut my right arm
exactly.
off to have 1.3%, 1.6% food inflation.
Exactly. Right. So it's not rocket science. There's nothing extraordinary that they're doing currently that makes that number extremely low.
Mm.
It's just a result of earlier reforms that they've put in place, and they're reaping the benefits. Some of those reforms are probably what the international donor community have been talking to Nigeria about as well, and we're hesitant to implement them currently as well. So there's really nothing extraordinary.
Nothing special.
Exactly.
Just put the reforms
put
in.
Put the reforms
and
in.
Let and, everything
and
play
let
every, out.
Exactly, without government intervention.
Great stuff. Benchmark interest rates, very interesting here. Like, we'll take a look at that and ask you why we're looking at benchmark rates for some of these countries. Okay, we only got a minute and 30 seconds. Very quickly, what about us here in Nigeria? How do we get down to why we're looking at that single digit inflation, if possible?
I mean, without sounding bearish about Nigeria, the current economic structure probably doesn't support inflation in extremely low digits like we have in some of these other countries.
Mm.
First, we have a prevailing supply gap where we produce much less than we consume.
Yep.
And with recourse to imports that are sometimes cheaper and even of better quality than what is produced locally. So our consumer prices are always going to be exposed to supply constraints and exchange rates volatilities. We also have the policy uncertainty in the environment that discourages private investment in some of these critical sectors that could temper pricing pressures. Delayed reforms as well contributes to discouraging private sector investment. A good example is the over a decade-long impasse of the PIGB,
right.
which is stalling investment in the oil sector. So we have all this unfavorable conditions that is contributing to the current economic malaise that would make it very unlikely for us to have low consumer prices. So, and the longer we delay with some of these things, we're just prolonging the dynamics and we're not going to get to where we want to get to. We've seen Egypt do it initially, stoked the economy. Now they're back to decent levels. Same thing with Senegal. So it just makes sense to do it quick when it's not as expensive as it is now, because the longer you take, the more expensive it will become.
Thank you so much. Mushopa, everybody. Economist with Inflection Capital Asset Managers. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.